Every so often, every now and then, one of you will write in and give one of our family members, like this one right here, you give them a challenge. And you're in the hot seat today, my friend, because you're going to find ways to repurpose old kitchen utensils that are around.
Yes, and I have to say, this is a good one because I have the same issue. Mm-hmm. So to remind people at home, so we got a lovely letter from Robyn from Rockport, Texas, mm-hmm. and she has a bunch of wooden utensils that's passed down. She doesn't use them and pleaded to me, what can I do?
I know. All right, so it just so happens that Robyn Smith from Rockport, Texas is joining us live. And
there she is.
Hi, Robyn.
Hey, Robyn.
Hi. Nice to see you.
First of all, thank you for challenging Ken. we encourage a lot of people to write in and challenge our family members. So you have a lot of utensils that you just don't know what to do or repurpose.
I do. I have a drawer full.
It's hard to get rid of them, huh?
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, it takes years to get them weathered.
I know, and then you there's some of these really old ones that are here that reminds me a lot of what my grandmother had.
Yeah, where are yours from, Robyn? Where have you collected those?
Oh, well, I love to cook, so I've just been collecting over the years.
Right.
Okay. All right, so stand by. Watch what Ken does here. Let's start with our first step.
Well, I have to bond with you because I do the same thing. I have this passion for kitchen utensils, and it's actually become quite chic, Robyn. I have like a pile of rolling pins in my dining room, which just sort of sit there looking beautiful. I have a great old bread bin in my kitchen. So you're right on track as far as design trends. Mm-hmm. There's my rolling pins. And the things are so beautiful and weathered.
Yeah.
And to me, you think of all the hands that have touched them, all the meals they've made, all the biscuits, all the pancakes, mm-hmm. that you just can't throw them away. So, and it's very chic right now. So I'm going to help you out.
So we have our utensils, right, Robyn. You can see we have utensils that Ken has as part of his
dump
family.
From my drawer.
Yes. So we have those lined up. What do we do from here?
So first thing you want to do, Robyn, is you want to make some sense out of them. So I'm just going to sort them. You want to sort them either by size, by material.
Color,
so that they're not just totally random, so they make some sense. So I've got sort of larger green-handled pieces. I've got my standard brown wood ones, and then I've got smaller, shorter, and then I've got miscellaneous.
What'd you say, Robyn? I didn't hear what you said.
He has fun ones.
Well,
I think they can all be fun, but you do find some really weird ones, and when I see those, I love to have them and hold on to them, but then what do you do with them?
I know, and some have never changed throughout the years, and others have and just have become obsolete. All right, so
we're going to start off with the big ones. So the big ones, a lot of big ones you'll see will already have holes in the handle because mm-hmm. people used to hang them. What I've done is I've gotten just an old cutting board. This is a great use for cutting boards that are damaged, that are warped. And I've put up at the top little brass nails that are just from a picture hanging kit. And this is as simple as you can get. All I'm going to do is put the nails right on there, spread them out evenly, mm-hmm. and just like that, boom, you have this sort of lovely, sort of semi-modern yet country sort of look.
Okay.
I'm going to give that to you.
All right. Put this here. All right. So.
So far, are you with me, Robyn?
I love it. That is,
okay.
That's great.
Super easy.
So what's next?
Now let's say if you don't have a cutting board.
Yeah, if we don't have a cutting board, what do we? Oh.
So right here, I've just got a piece of wood plaque. This came from a craft store, and I'm going to do the same thing, but with pieces without the hole, you just have to get creative. I've used the larger brass nails, and you just have to find a way to secure them. And here, I've added a little bit of double stick tape. I don't want to nail or use super glue or anything because, in my mind, these are valuable emotionally, if not sort of financially. Again, a little piece of double stick tape. And I'm just lining up all the small ones the same, all on a piece with the little nail on just a piece of craft wood. And all of a sudden, you have sort of a nice little set here that you can hang in the kitchen and would look
okay.
lovely. Now,
she's got wooden ones, right? Or you have another one there?
Well, just to show you... everyone at home, when you get weird things like egg beaters, you have to just get creative. Here I just done big screws, and I'm just going to hook those screws on. So really, you have to look at each piece and figure out a way to mount it that will work for that piece, Robyn.
So,
God, that one's beautiful.
So, all right. So,
Robyn. Let's go with the basic wooden. That's what you've got. Let's see those puppies again.
What do you got?
See, there you go. All right. So I'm with you here. So with these, because they're wood, you really want that beauty. As you say, they've been weathered. You want that to pop. So Robyn, what you're going to do, again, a piece of craft wood. And what I did here was I picked leftover paint from our kitchen cabinets. So it's going to tie right in with your kitchen. And then all you're going to do is do the exact same thing. I'm going to use a little bit of hot glue. The nice thing about hot glue is that it will grip the pieces, but it's not going to damage them if you end up wanting to pop them off later.
Robyn, are you a hot gluer?
I love hot glue.
Isn't it amazing? It's highly satisfying material to work with.
And what colors are you working with in your kitchen, Robyn?
I'm doing the black and white, really.
Oh, wow, that'd be fantastic.
This on a weathered black board with like a white dry brush and then the utensils would be fabulous.
Okay.
So boom, all you do is do that, and you've all of a sudden it makes those really warm colors pop.
Other than the utensils, do you have any oddly shaped things? Because I know, Ken, you have another tip for that, but is there anything that's old that doesn't quite fit this schematic so far?
Sifter.
All right, that's great.
Old
so with something like that, especially like really sneak. So I've got this old T10 and a strainer, which I love. It's from an old hotel. So you can take sort of special things like that. Here I got again a wood plaque. I painted a blue. I picked a color that was in the tea box, a pair of brackets at the bottom to hold it, and a piece of double stick tape. And then at the top here, I'm going to. This is what you do with the sifter. Robyn, when you've got sort of things that are different heights, I just did a little spool that's the same color. I painted the same color, and that's going to lift the handle up so that you can actually, like, so it will be roughly the same height. Then again, a little bit of hot glue here. I'm going to put this here, and then with the sifter, take a little bitty nail that you can barely see and right through the sifter screen.
Tap
that little nail in so you won't see it.
And you're set.
And then you can mount that. You know, a sifter with, you could get like an old bag of flour, frame the flour, put the flour and the sifter together, and that would be
smart.
Adorable as well.
Have we helped you at all, Robyn?
Immensely.
Wonderful.
I had no idea what to do with them.
It looks great here, but Robyn, we have a shot of it up on the wall. You don't even have to put it in your kitchen.
Beautiful.
It can be in your dining room.
Yeah.
You can put it in a little place where you have tea. Up on the wall, it looks absolutely fabulous. It can really change your room.
Wonderful. And I think you've taken that challenge on head on, and do you think he succeeded, Robyn?
Absolutely. That's why I asked.
Okay.
And will you promise me you'll actually do this, Robyn?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I can do that.
You can do that, which is even better. Thank you so much.
Send us photos.
And thank you for watching. If you have a challenge for Ken or any of our family members and you're watching the show right now, please
bring it on, baby.
Careful. There's a lot of talented people
I know,
watching.
It's true.
All right. For more information on how you can perform this DIY, you can head over to our website, hallmarkchannel.com.